welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gaudin, getting set for quarter number three here.
He's set to kick off.
It'll be Falcons football, and they trail here as we get back underway on EA Sports. Takes this about 5 yards deep. Ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
At their own 23-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm the whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. Now Ito Smith. He'll get about four as he's past the 35 to the 38-yard line.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
From the 38, Ryan gets this one to Hill. Take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
First and 10 at the 48-yard line.
Here's Ryan. And Jones has it over the middle. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
First down.
Now Ryan on first down. Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. Samson Ebukam showing his strength and quickness there. A loss of four. Second down, here's Smith. Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
Third and long, it's Ryan. Turn the out route and complete. It's Jones.
All that practice time came to fruition on that play. All those timing routes that they work on through training camp, OTAs, mini camp, and just regular season, they got it done on that one. An outcut, ball was delivered, and picked up the completion.
They'll try and throw for it with Ryan. And he's got a man, Calvin Ridley. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains. First down carry for Smith, and he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
It's a gain of five. Brings up second and five.
They'll run it again with Smith. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. They'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. On third down, Ryan. It's caught, Jones. And the Falcons are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
3 yard line.
Yardage back to the 4 yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
It's a loss of one. Bring brings up second and goal at the 4-yard line.
Another try for Smith. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down.
It's third down and goal to go.
For the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
The field goal doesn't help. They're going to go for the 6 here on fourth and goal. They're going on fourth down. It's Ryan. And this is incomplete. After breaking up by David Long in the defensive end. So they finally get their first trip to the red zone, and it ends with nothing.
That's what I'm going to focus on with you, because you teed it up really well. Finally get to the red zone. So there's got to be a little bit of frustration because they haven't moved the ball as well as they wanted to all game. Now they get there, but we got to go for it because we don't know if we can get back here again. We don't know how many opportunities because they've been sputtering a little bit.
Absolutely. At this stage in the second half, to get there and not get it for the first time, Tom. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
At the 5-yard line.
Loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Out of the gun. Goff. That's into the hands of Akers. Complete. And he'll take this one up to about the 6-yard line. Give him 2 yards on that play. And it'll be third and 10 now.
Third down.
Here's Goff. And they set up the screen. That's complete. And they work this out past the 25. Nice third down conversion at even 20 yards. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. Goff with a pass caught by Reynolds. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
A gain of 19 yards.
First down, Akers. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
He was tackled at the 46-yard line. A gain of a yard. Brings up
Goff going to throw it. And he fires one that's intercepted. He's picked off just shy of midfield.
Another day, baby.
It's a foot race. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Falcon defense has a touchdown. This game's still fairly well in hand, but I think now you go conservative, don't you? Go into your shell and just run the football.
I think you have to, but you also have to tell your backs, make sure you're really protecting the football, because you're going to run into a stacked defensive front, which is why they were throwing the football before, trying to make sure they didn't sit in their backs, you know, really beat up in that situation. Now, good luck to them.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Looking up into the roof, and he muffs it. It's loose. An incredibly short kick fielded way up there.
Webster on the return. The Rams take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use him at this point. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Second and 3.
back to Akers.
And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
On third down, here's a run by Akers. And he'll lose yardage here. Back to the 15. Defensively, they rallied the troops to force fourth down after that 7-yard pickup back on first. And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. They go ahead and snap it. Gone.